Hey everyone, Holden here with Gold Plating Services. Today we're going to be talking about our Surface Activator. Our Surface Activator is a part of the Activator family and is the second step in the electroplating process. This should be done after your item has been wet out by the electroclean. In this video, we will be talking about what metals work with the Surface Activator, why activation is important, what Surface Activator needs to work, and what to look for when using Surface Activator. Here's a list of common metals that we recommend using with the Surface Activator. It is very important to note that Surface Activator will not work with stainless steel, steel, or items with high chromium content. You'll need to use another activator for these metals, such as wood nickel strike or trivalve gold strike. If you're interested, you can see the product pages for more information. The Surface Activator is just one of the many activators we provide and is one of the most common ones used in the electroplating process. So what is surface activation? The activation or strike step is when a surface is prepared to have the next plate deposited onto it. When done properly, when the next metal, such as nickel or gold, is applied to it, it will deposit the metal onto the surface without flaking or easily coming off with the tape test. If the activation is not done correctly, then the metal may not deposit onto the surface properly, and it could come off easily by either flaking or pulling up with the tape test. Here's an example of the tape test when the item is not activated properly. And here's the tape test when the item is activated properly. The activation step is a quick step, only needing to be done for about 15 to 30 seconds. Be careful not to overactivate your part. This can damage the surface that you're plating onto, and the most common consequence of that is darkening of the surface. In order for the surface activator to work properly, you'll need just a few things. The first thing is a correct anode. For bath plating, you'll need a graphite or a stainless steel anode, and for brush plating, you'll need a stainless steel anode. Next, you're going to need the proper plating equipment for surface activator to work. For both brush and bath plating, you'll need a power supply that will allow you to adjust your voltage from 0 to 12 volts. The surface activator solution does not need to be heated, and it can work effectively at room temperature. And the surface activator will be the same solution for both brush and the bath plating processes. We're going to look at the process of using the surface activator. We're going to first start off by electrocleaning our item. This will make it so the surface of the item is wet out. You want to make sure to rinse your item off properly before going on to our surface activator. At this point, your item should be wet out and should be placed into the surface activator. So now we'll go into our surface activator, and you can see that there is bubbles coming off of this, and we'll do this for about 15 to 30 seconds, and our item should be activated. When brush plating, it is important to not let the surface dry out between electrocleaner and the surface activator step. You also want to make sure that the surface is properly rinsed off between each step to avoid contamination. You will want to activate the same area that you electroclean, but leave a small buffer zone for the electrocleaner. You want to make sure you properly rinse off this area and that everything is still wet out and there's no activator left on the surface. If surface activator is not rinsed off properly, then it will most likely over-attack the surface and leave a darkening that might not be visible until your next solution is applied. When brush plating with the surface activator, it is important that you brush plate your item for about 15 to 30 seconds per square inch of area. All right, everyone, I hope this video was helpful in learning more about our surface activator. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.